Hello everyone, this is Kunal and today we'll study about depreciation. So before beginning, let me introduce you. I'm Kunal from Delhi and I'm teaching accountancy from more than 5 years, and I am also visiting faculty at USC UniQuest. It's a venture of IGI and Sikshapit College, and I'm also associated with Urban Pro from so many years. And this webinar we are organizing to help students of class 11th for a depreciation, and I hope this will help you in clearing your all doubts. So let's begin without wasting any time. So first of all, I'll tell you what is I'll tell you what we are going to study in this chapter, or what we are going to study in this webinar. So in this webinar, I'm covering the meaning of depreciation. We'll understand what exactly depreciation is. We'll study the meaning and definition of depreciation. Then next, we'll study the difference between depreciation, amortization, and depletion. What exactly the difference between depreciation, amortization, and depletion? Then we'll study the factor or basis of providing depreciation. But all factors which affect, like for charging depreciation, we'll study that. After that, we'll study the method of recording of depreciation, like how we pass the accounting entries, what are the journal entries we pass for accounting the depreciation. Next, we'll study the method of depreciation. We have so many methods, mainly straight line method and written down value method. We'll study that. And next, we'll study sale or disposal of asset. In this, we'll calculate the amount of profit or loss on sale of any asset. And then we'll do some practical question. Okay, so I hope this will help you. So let's start with the meaning of depreciation. First of all, we'll understand what exactly depreciation is. In simple language, I can say if we buy a new asset, for example, any asset, you can say it may be land, it may be building, it may be furniture, any tangible asset. So we have, like, for example, we buy a new building for rupees 1 lakh rupees. So we have its exact expected useful life. What we say, expected useful life. Any building, maybe we use it for next 10 years or maybe 12 years or 15 years. We cannot calculate the exact useful life, but yes, we can estimate it. For example, we estimate its expected useful life is 10 years. So the new building is costing us rupees 1 lakh and it will last for 10 years. So we can say every year its value going down by rupees 10,000. So this 10,000, we call it as a depreciation. Depreciation is charged due to various reason, like due to efflux of time, like due to obsolescence, like due to accident. We'll study each and every factor of charging depreciation in detail. So in simple manner, I can say if you buy a new laptop for rupees 50,000 and it is expected useful life is 5 years, then we can say every year its cost is going down by rupees 10,000. Okay, so this is we call depreciation. So now let's understand what I have written here. Depreciation means fall in the value of tangible fixed asset. Here we note that this depreciation is charged on tangible fixed assets. It is not charged on intangible fixed assets. On intangible fixed asset, we charge amortization. So there is a difference between depreciation and amortization. So this depreciation is charged due to various reasons. First reason is like the usage. If you use any asset, then depreciation will be charged. Then second reason is efflux of time. It means if you are using any asset, every day its value is going down due to usage. Third is obsolescence. Obsolescence means like change in fashion. Change in fashion. or you can say change in technology. This is the reason of obsolescence. Okay. And then is accident. These are mainly four reasons of charging depreciation. Depreciation, we charge depreciation on all assets except land. Like we charge depreciation on land, building, furniture, machinery, on every tangible fixed asset. But we do not charge depreciation on land. Why we don't charge depreciation on land? Because it has infinite economic life. What do you mean by infinite economic life? It means land will last forever. Land, you know, you understand land like vacant land. On that we like construct a building. So land has infinite life. That's why we don't charge depreciation on land. And depreciation is an expense which do not involve cash outflow. What does it mean? It means that like we charge depreciation, like we have expenses. There are two kind of expenses. One where cash outflow is involved and other where cash outflow is not involved. Let's understand where cash outflow is involved. First, like if we pay the salary, like we pay to someone who comes to us and we pay the amount of salary, there is cash outflow. And for example, we are paying the rent, then we are paying rent to the landlord, then there will be a cash outflow. Okay, but in case of depreciation, we do not pay any amount to any third person. He is not coming to our office and asking for the amount of depreciation. That's why we say like depreciation is expense which does not involve the cash outflow. I hope you got that. So now let's move to other slide. I hope you understood the meaning of depreciation. Next, let me erase this. Okay, so now let's study these some important definition of depreciation which you can see in your books as well. First definition is given, depreciation is a permanent and continuing diminution in the quality, quantity and value of asset. It means that depreciation is not temporary. It is not temporary. It is charged on permanent basis. Okay. So like, it's not like that we are charging depreciation for some years, then we'll not charge depreciation for some other years. No. You have to charge depreciation every year and it is a continuing process. Okay, so depreciation is a permanent and continuing diminution in quality, quantity and value of asset. Depreciation can be defined as a measure of exhaustion of the effective life of asset of any cause during the given period. Like if we use any asset, then it will remain for some years, it get exhausted after some years, it have some effective life. So for that effective life, we charge depreciation. This is the second definition. Third is diminution is depreciation is diminution in intrinsic value of asset due to use or lapse of time. For your exams, you just learn the meaning. Definition are not as much important. You just focus on the meaning with what we studied in the last slides. Okay. So now let's move to next slide. Now let's understand the characteristics of depreciation. Like what are the features you can say in depreciation? First one is depreciation. It is a fall in the book value. What is book value? The value which we show in books of accounts. The value which we show in books of accounts is called as book value. Okay. It is a fall in the book value of tangible fixed asset. We have already studied what is tangible fixed asset. It is a permanent, gradual and continuing nature. It is a process of allocation of cost. What do you mean by allocation of cost? Here allocation of cost means if you buy a new machinery for rupees 1 lakh, then we allocate its cost to number of years. For example, its useful life is 5 years. Then per year depreciation would be 20,000 rupees and we allocate this amount. What we do? We allocate this amount over the expected useful life of the asset. Expected useful life is here is 5 years. So we charge depreciation 20,000 and we debit in P&L account every year. Okay. Depreciation is indirect expense. We know in accountancy, we have two type of expenses. First is direct expenses. And second one is indirect expenses. Direct expenses, which are directly related to manufacture, which we show in trading account. And indirect expenses are all those expenses which are not directly related to manufacture, which we show in profit and loss account. So here depreciation is indirect expense, which is debited to P&L account. This will help you in your final account chapter as well. In final account, we show the depreciation and we also do some adjustments related to depreciation. Okay. Now, next point is it is charged on all tangible fixed assets such as building, furniture and machinery except land. We have already studied that, like, depreciation is charged on all fixed assets except land. Okay, so now let's move to other slide. Let's understand the meaning of depreciation, amortization and depletion. Most of the time we get confused, like we think like depreciation, amortization and depletion is the same thing, but it's not like that. There is a difference between depreciation, amortization and depletion. We have already studied what exactly depreciation is. So now let's study what is amortization. Amortization is charged on intangible assets, on intangible asset. You know what are intangible asset? Intangible asset, for example, goodwill, patent, trademark, copyright, all these assets are called as intangible assets. So on intangible asset, the value which goes down every year, because we cannot say intangible asset will be for exist for infinite period. It's not like that. Even intangible asset have some definite or finite life. So that is why we charge amortization. Amortization is a gradual or systematically return off intangible asset over its estimated useful life. Okay. Now let's understand what's the meaning of depletion. Depletion means depletion we charge on something like mines, or material we extract from mines. For example, from mines we extract coal, or from mines we extract something like other minerals. So you know, some companies are involved. Some companies, have you heard the name of Jindal Power, Jindal Steel or Jindal Power? They are involved in extracting minerals from the mines. So even they have also some limited life of minerals in mines. So for that we also charge depletion. Depletion is charged as a measure of exhaustion of wasting assets such as extraction of material from mines, etc. Okay, so I hope you understood the meaning of first is depreciation, second one is amortization, and third one is depletion. So now let's move to further. Now let's understand why we charge depreciation. Okay, what is the objective of providing depreciation? Mainly there are four objectives of charging depreciation. Let's understand. First one is to calculate correct profit or loss. Like, if we do not charge depreciation, then we are not able to calculate correct profit or loss, because we debit the depreciation amount in profit and loss account. We have P&L account from where we get the net profit or net loss. So if we do not charge depreciation, then we will not be able to calculate the correct profit or correct loss. Okay, so for that we charge depreciation, otherwise our profit will not be correct. Second reason is to show the true and fair view of financial position. You know that we charge depreciation in balance sheet as well. In balance sheet, we deduct the amount of depreciation from asset. Like we prepare the balance sheet and asset side, we have, for example, building. From building, we deduct the amount of depreciation. Let's say if we don't do that, if we don't deduct the amount of depreciation, then our financial position will not be correct. Because we are not charging, we are not deducting the amount of depreciation, then amount of building will remain every year same, which is not correct. So to show the true and fair view of financial position, here financial position means balance sheet, we charge depreciation. Third reason is to show the asset at its proper value. If we don't charge the depreciation, then asset will be overvalued. Assets will be overvalued, which is also not correct. Third, fourth, to retain out of profit funds for replacement. What do you mean by replacement? For example, if you buy a new laptop for rupees 50,000 and it will last for 5 years, then after 5 years, what will happen? You again have to buy a new laptop. For that, you need require the funds. So what you should plan? You should charge 10,000 rupees every year from your profit so that after 5 years, you have the money for replacement of the assets. Okay. So this is the reason we charge depreciation. Depreciation is charged for replacement of asset as well. I hope all four objectives are clear to you. So now let's move further. Let's understand the factors of providing depreciation. Mainly there are three factors for providing depreciation. First one is original cost. Second one is estimated residual value or scrap value. And third one is estimated useful life. Now let's understand all these factors in detail. First one is original cost or historical cost. What is original cost? Original cost is the price which we pay for the asset at the time of acquisition. For example, if we buy a new asset for rupees 1 lakh, then that 1 lakh rupees will be called as original cost or historical cost. Okay. Now let's understand what is estimated scrap value. We cannot determine the exact value of scrap because we don't know how much money we get from the sale of asset at the end of its useful life. We may get 20,000, we may get 30,000, even we may get 10,000. So we don't know the exact amount of asset at the end of its useful life. So that's the reason we only estimate the amount of scrap value. Third is estimated useful life. What is estimated useful life? We cannot predict exactly what will be the useful life of the asset. Do you know that how many years the laptop will last? If you buy a new laptop, how many years it will last? We don't know. It may be for 5 years. It may be for 10 years. We don't know. So how we calculate estimated useful life? We take the opinion of experts because they know what will be the estimated useful life of the computer. We know, we take this help of experts to know the estimated scrap value in the market at the end of its useful life. So we cannot predict it exactly. That's why we take the opinion of experts who is expert in computer industry or laptop. So these three factors we calculate to know the amount of depreciation. Let's understand each factor in detail. First is original cost. How we calculate the original cost? Original cost is purchase price plus freight plus installation cost. If we add the three factors, then we get original cost. For example, if we buy a new machinery from Japan, then purchase price would be 1 lakh. freight. What do you mean by freight? It's a transportation cost. If we bring the asset from Japan, then we have to take it out, like we purchase either by air or by sea, whatever mode, then we have to pay the freight cost, which will be, you can assume, 20,000. And installation cost, for example, we need some technician to install that machinery at our place or at our office, so then it will cost rupees 10,000. Total cost will be rupees 1,30,000. Okay, so this will be what original cost. Then we calculate estimated scrap value. You can assume, for example, at the end of its useful life, you will get rupees 30,000. Then this will be estimated scrap value. Now we calculate estimated useful life. Physical life is not important. Asset may still exist physically, but may not capable of producing goods at reasonable cost. At the end of useful life, you can see asset may exist physically, but it may not able to provide you any production. Okay. So then estimated useful life, for example, you assume 5 years. Then how we calculate the depreciation? We use the simple formula. Let's understand. We have formula for that, for calculating depreciation in the straight line method. I'm writing here for you. Depreciation is equal to original cost less estimated scrap value divided by estimated useful life. Okay, like we assumed original cost is rupees 1,30,000. The original cost 1,30,000. Estimated scrap value kitni assume kari thi humne? We assumed it rupees 30,000. And estimated useful life, we assumed 5 years. So now let's calculate. It will be 20,000 rupees. Okay. So this is what? This is depreciation of any asset under straight line method. Okay, now let's understand the methods of recording depreciation. We have two methods of recording depreciation. First one, when provision for depreciation account is not maintained. And then we have second method, when provision for depreciation account is maintained. In depreciation, we do two type of accounting, wherein we record depreciation through accumulated depreciation account. One where we prepare provision for depreciation account, and second where we do not prepare provision for depreciation account. In your T.S. Girewal book, you can see there are two methods. First one is when provision for depreciation account is not maintained, and second one is when provision for depreciation account is maintained. We have two methods of recording depreciation. Provision for depreciation is also known by accumulated depreciation account. This is its secondary name. You can call it as provision for depreciation is also known by accumulated depreciation account. So let's understand what's the exact difference between how we record depreciation when provision for depreciation account is maintained and provision for depreciation account is not maintained. It's very simple. So sometimes students get confused and they assume that both the methods are same, but it's not like that. So now let's understand. First one is when provision for depreciation account is maintained. Here you can also say depreciation is charged or credited to asset account. First, let's understand what is the journal entry of depreciation. The journal entry for depreciation is depreciation account debit to asset account. Depreciation is a nominal account. We know nominal account, rule of nominal account, expenses, losses always debit and income gain always credit. So depreciation is an expense account, so we debit it. Then asset, here value of asset is decreasing, and when asset decreases we credit it. Okay, then we this is the entry for being depreciation charge on asset. Then we transfer the depreciation to profit and loss account. Then second entry will be P&L account debit to depreciation account. Okay, this is when provision for depreciation account is not maintained. This is provision for depreciation account is not maintained. This is first method. So now let's understand the second method. This is the second method where provision for depreciation or depreciation account is maintained. Here we are maintaining the account. Provision for depreciation account is maintained. Now you see what's the difference between the entry. This entry is got changed. Earlier we were passing entry depreciation account debit to asset account. In previous method we passed this entry, but here depreciation account is debit to provision for depreciation account. So we are not creating the depreciation in the asset account. We are preparing separate account for provision for depreciation. Okay, so why we are doing like this? Because we don't want to like change our asset account. We want depreciation to be carried separately. We don't want to disturb our asset account. We want depreciation is to be carried on other account. That's why we are charging depreciation to provision for depreciation account. Next entry will remain same as we did in previous method. P&L account debit to depreciation. So there are two methods. First, when provision for depreciation account is maintained, and second, when provision for depreciation account is not maintained. Okay, so now let's move to further. Now we have two methods, which is one is called as straight line method and second one is called as written down value method. In short, we say it as SLM method, and in short we call it as WDV method. First is straight line method and second one is WDV method. This is also known like by fixed percentage on original cost or fixed installment method. This is called as fixed percentage on diminishing balance or reducing installment method. So there are two methods of charging depreciation. First one is straight line method and second one is WDV method. Let's understand. First, let's understand how to calculate depreciation under a straight line method. I have given one example here. Let's study. First method, if asset costs rupees 5 lakh and rate of depreciation is 10%, 50,000 will be written off every year. How we calculated depreciation? Here simply we applied 5 lakh into rate, that is 10% per annum, then it will be 50,000 every year. And how many years the cost of asset will become zero? If you see, we are charging depreciation every year 50,000. First year 50, second year again 50, third year again 50, fourth year again 50. So we are charging depreciation every year 50,000. So in 10 years, the cost of asset will become zero. So first feature of straight line method is that the cost of asset will become zero in books after its useful life. See my second example. If asset residual value at the end, here residual value of asset is given, that is 50,000, and number of years is 10 years. The formula is original cost less estimated residual value divided by number of years. So 5 lakh minus 50,000, this is estimated scrap value divided by number of years, you get depreciation 45,000. So it's very easy. It's not very difficult. You just have to apply the formula. You just have the basic knowledge. It's a like a layman can know if you buy some asset, like if buy a new calculator for rupees 500 and this will last for 10 years, then how much it's costing me every year? It's costing me every year rupees 50. So it's a simple, you can say, simple concept. Now let's move further. This is the, you can see I have summarized the straight line method. Equal amount is written off every year. In straight line method, equal amount is written off every year. In previous example, we have seen that every year we are charging rupees 50,000. So equal amount is written off every year. Second feature is, it is a simple method. You have to just apply the formula. There is no complexity involved. So it's very simple to calculate the depreciation under straight line method. So you can say it's a very simple method. Asset given equal utility throughout the life. We are assuming the utility. Utility means how much we are using or how much asset is providing us the utility. We are assuming it's the same utility every year. But practically it is not like that. When we buy a new asset in initial years, the asset provide very good utility, you can say, but in later years the utility of assets get decline or decreases. Like if I buy a new mobile phone, then in initial 1 or 2 years it will work very effectively, but when you use mobile in your third year, fourth year or fifth year, you can see your mobile goes hang or something, you get problem, it takes time to run any app or something like that. So in straight line method, we are assuming the asset is given as a equal utility every year. Now let's understand how we calculate the depreciation under written down value method. Example, I'm reading example for you. A Limited acquired machinery on 1st April 2014 at a cost of rupees 90,000 and spent 10,000 on its installation. Okay, so you already know any amount incurred for installation of new machinery will be added to the cost of machinery. So I'm giving you 1 minute, just calculate the amount of depreciation. I'm giving you just 30 seconds, not 1 minute. Can you calculate the amount of depreciation for first year, second year, third year and fourth year? Company follows the accounting year, calculate the depreciation for 5 years. So now I am calculating the cost of asset, original cost, original cost here would be 90,000 plus 10,000, so original cost will be 1 lakh, okay, and the rate of depreciation is 10% per annum. So first year depreciation would be 10% of 1 lakh, it will be 10,000. Okay. Then second year, let's see, I have given the solution to you. No. Okay, I'm calculating. Second year, I have to clean this before calculating. Yeah, now original cost is rupees 1 lakh. For first year, depreciation would be 10,000. The balance value will be 90,000. In written down value method, we charge depreciation on the balance value. So second year, we charge depreciation on 90,000. So 10% of 90,000 is 9,000. Balance value will be 81,000. Third year, again we charge depreciation, but here we charge depreciation on balance value. So this will something like this. You know, depreciation is first year depreciation 10,000, second year 9,000, third year 8,100. Can you see depreciation is declining every year? This is not happening in straight line method. In straight line method, the amount of depreciation is same or fixed every year. It's not going to change. You can say the amount of depreciation is constant in straight line method. But in written down value method, the amount of depreciation is decreasing. First year 10,000, second year 9,000, third year 8,100. If you calculate for further, fourth year 7,290. Okay, now let's understand further. Written down value method. In written down value method, this method is accepted by Income Tax Act. We have so many acts like Income Tax Act, Companies Act, GST Act, further so many acts. So even written down value method is recognized. It is recognized by Income Tax Act. Income Tax Act says you must follow written down value method. They only accept written down value method. Written down value method also consider the repair and maintenance. What does it mean? It means that in first year we are charging depreciation 10,000 in previous example, second year 9,000, third year 8,100. So this is also making consistent with the repair or maintenance. In initial year, any asset does not involve any repair. But in later years, the cost of repairs goes high. In initial years, cost of repairs is very low. But in later years, the cost of repairs is very high. So this makes consistent the amount of depreciation. We'll study it further when we study the difference between the straight line method and WDV method. Okay. Revenue is charged uniform. Uniform means consistent or same. Okay. Let's move further. Now let's understand what is the difference between straight line method and written down value method. This is very important for your examination point of view. This is, you can mark it as most important for your examination. Let's understand. Depreciation is calculated on original cost. Depreciation is calculated on written down value. First difference is here we are charging depreciation on original cost, and here we are charging depreciation on written down value method. Okay. The amount of depreciation remains same. For example, the amount of depreciation is 10,000 every year. It's not going to change. The amount of depreciation is reduces every year. Here, amount of depreciation is going down. Like first year 10,000, second year 9,000. Okay, third year 8,100, something like that. Third is the balance in asset account will be zero at the expiry of working life of asset. The value of asset will become zero at the end of its useful life. If we charge depreciation 10,000 for 10 years, then it will be 1 lakh. Then in books, its value will be zero. So this is the method. This is very simple method. In the balance of asset account will not reduce to zero. You can say in straight line WDV method, the value of asset will become approximate to zero, but it will not be exact zero. It will be approximate to zero. Like for example, if cost of asset remain 10 rupees, then depreciation 1 rupees, then written down value rupees 9. Then again, you charge depreciation on 9 rupees, so 0.9. Then again, value is 9 minus 0.9. Then it will be 8.1. So this will not be zero exactly. Straight line method is easy to calculate. It is little difficult. Next point is the combined cost on account of depreciation and repair is lower in initial year and higher in later year. Here we are just comparing both the cost, depreciation plus repair. See, the cost of repair is high in initial years and low in later years. But amount of depreciation remain constant in straight line method. In straight line method, the amount of depreciation will remain constant, but the repair will be high in later years, but less in initial years. Here again, we are talking about the depreciation and repairs remain more or less or equal to same at the end of its period. Here again, we are comparing the depreciation plus repair. Here, amount of depreciation is high in initial years, but less in later years. So this is the difference between straight line method and written down value method. I hope you understood this. Now let's move to further and let's understand how we calculate profit or loss on sale of asset. Now let's calculate how we are calculating profit or loss on sale of asset. I give you one example for this. For example, we buy a new asset on 1st April 2015. For example, machinery purchased for rupees 1 lakh, and on 1st April 2019 we sold this asset sold, for example, for rupees 40,000. Okay, now let's assume depreciation is 5% under straight line method. So can you calculate the amount of depreciation and also the profit or loss on sale of asset? We have used this asset for 2015 to 19. It means you can say for 4 years. Now we use this tabular sheet. I'm using it for you. First, we calculate the sale price. I have given you, we are selling this asset at rupees 40,000. So we put this amount here. The sale price is 40,000. Now we deduct the book value of the asset on the date of sale. Here book value, we have to calculate this value. We purchased this asset for rupees 1 lakh on 1st April 2015. So we used it for, let's calculate depreciation. This will be 10,000, 5% depreciation amount will be 5% of 1 lakh, 5%. This will be 5,000. So for first year again 5,000, second year 5,000, third year 5,000, fourth year 5,000. So 1 lakh minus 5,000 for 4 years. So value will be 80,000. So book value will be 80,000. Now we are calculating the profit or loss. We are selling the asset at rupees 40,000. And the book value is 80,000. So the profit, there will be a loss because we are selling it at a below the book value. Book value is 80,000 and selling price is 40,000. So we have loss of rupees 40,000. So I hope you understood how we calculate profit or loss. As a layman, we cannot say we purchased the asset for 1 lakh and sold it for 40,000. So we got a loss of rupees 60,000. This is not the correct. We have to calculate first book value. Then we calculate the loss or profit on the sale of asset. I hope you understood this. Now let's move further. This is our last part. Now let's summarize what we studied. in 2 to 5 minutes. We covered the following topics: meaning of depreciation. I hope you got the meaning of depreciation now. Depreciation is a fall in the value of tangible assets due to wear and tear, reflux of time, obsolescence. Okay. You understood the meaning of depreciation, amortization, and depletion. Amortization, we charge on intangible assets. Depletion on mines, coal, on wasting assets. Factor, we have three factors: original cost, estimated useful life, estimated scrap value, and estimated three things: original cost, estimated useful life, and estimated scrap value. Next, method of recording depreciation. One is when we make the provision for depreciation account. Another is when we do not maintain the provision for depreciation account. Next we started method of depreciation, straight line method, and written down value method. We started in detail the amount of depreciation remain constant in straight line method, and the amount of depreciation is decreasing in written down value method. And we calculated sale and disposable of asset, like how we calculate profit or loss on sale of asset. Then we did some small question examples. I hope you found this webinar very useful. And if you feel like this webinar was very useful for you, then let us know in comment box or in feedback section. Thank you very much. Happy learning.